If you're interested in the Presenting to the Emergency Room mug or other Chubby Emu merch, link to my store is in the description below. Hey, Dr. Bernard here. I recently made a video on Chubby Emu about someone who chugged 12 energy drinks in 10 minutes. I remember this guy coming through the emergency room and no one knew that he had chugged all those energy drinks until he told everyone much later. Pancreatitis was pretty straightforward to pick out, severe abdominal pain radiating to the back, with nausea and vomiting, and just the most insanely elevated serum lipase level. The vast majority of acute pancreatitis comes from gallstones, alcohol, or high triglycerides, a lot of times in the setting of diabetes. The patient didn't have any of those, although he was pre-diabetic. There's not that many people chugging huge amounts of energy drinks all the time to give us the same data that we have for alcoholics and diabetics when it comes to pancreatitis, but it does appear that there could be an association with excess energy drink consumption and pancreatitis, which I may have experienced myself. When the patient in the Chubby Emu video came through, it reminded me of a time in my life 10 years earlier from that point where I chugged 6 energy drinks in 15 minutes. And while I was making the Chubby Emu video, it also reminded me of a different time after JS had presented to the emergency room when energy drinks cured my insomnia. When I was 16, I was working my first job washing dishes at a restaurant. I remember the chef paid me less than minimum wage, and his rationale for it was that he wanted me to become a culinary person. You know, you work your way up from dishwasher to busboy to something in between, all the way up to a line cook and so on. This was a very small restaurant, and they only opened on the weekends. The place sat like 12 people. It was a couple $100 per person for a 5-course meal, and this was like 20 years ago. But restaurant working culture today is probably not very different from back then. You see, the actual line cooks at that restaurant were like 20-something-year-old guys, and they thought it would be funny if they challenged me. Bernard, we got 6 cans of this energy drink, and you know, tonight's gonna be a really busy night. Some of the tables are actually double booked. It's gonna be a fire hazard in the dining area, and it's gonna be an absolute fire hazard for you washing those dishes. We need you to do double time, and you know what? We'll give you $25 for your trouble if you finish all 6 of these cans in 15 minutes. And being 16, thinking that it was funny, I did it, and it was awful. I could feel my heart beating in my neck. I almost threw up in the sink every 5 minutes, and I had to grip the dishwasher handle and squeeze as hard as I could, just so that I wouldn't empty my guts out everywhere. They thought it was hilarious. Apparently, the chef got pissed when he found out what had happened, because my skin was pale gray. He almost sent me home. He did a load of dishes on his own in between reservations because I was just sitting on milk crates in the back, huddled over in pain. I was in a world of hurt. And I did have abdominal pain that radiated to my back, so who knows, maybe that night I had acute pancreatitis from those energy drinks. Mild cases self-resolve, so who knows. I didn't sleep that night either because I was too wired from all the caffeine. Basically, after that night, I didn't touch any energy drink for like 10 years. There was a short stint where I had like a can a day because I could buy the big 24 case from Costco, but I stopped that pretty quick. Actually, because of patient JS from the Chubby Emu video. His situation basically brought back all the restaurant memories, and I just never bought another Costco case afterwards. Now, fast forward to 2017. I had been on YouTube for about 2 years at that point. In the beginning of the year, I did a fat loss vlog. I lost around 40 pounds, and I kept it off. I take personal videos where I talk about daily things happening in my life, and looking back at my own records, I describe what I ate at that time, what I had for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. And what I didn't realize that was happening at that time, but I can see it now because I can watch those videos back, is that the amount that I was eating was gradually becoming less and less as 2017 went on. I didn't just stop at the 40 pounds of weight lost, I kept going. You can kind of see it in the medical videos that were made that year. I stopped doing cardio, but also I just didn't eat as much because I just didn't want to. It really wasn't even a conscious effort, I just didn't eat a lot. And this really became a problem on the exact day of October 12th, 2017. It was a Thursday. That day, I had a meeting at the National Institute of Health here in DC, and I had a colleague from Germany who had flown in the day before who was going to join me at this meeting. Like, I had to be there no matter what. I remember I had to get up at like 5 a.m. for some reason for this meeting, so the night before, I went to bed early. But no matter what I did, I just couldn't fall asleep. I was tossing and turning. I turned on the fan because I thought that my legs were too warm. I moved to the other side of my bed because I thought that the side that I was sleeping on had become too warm, but nothing would work. I thought I was sweating, so I went to take a cold shower to the point where I was shivering. But then that shivering made my body even warmer. I opened up a book to try to read myself to sleep, but then 3 a.m. rolled around and my eyes were wide open. Nothing was happening.
It's 4 in the morning. 4:20 in the morning. Up. I have to go to this NIH conference in literally 2 hours. Haven't slept. And then later today, I'm gonna have to drive to Philadelphia. How am I gonna do it?
All right, it's 4:22 a.m., October 12th, 2017, Thursday, all right?
My mind was mush for that meeting. I don't remember anything about it. The problem is, this wasn't a one-off. The next night, I still couldn't fall asleep. Now, I had to be on call and do overnights a lot at one point of my life, but usually I'll have had some kind of nap or something to just cover for that time awake, but it didn't happen the next day on October 13th and the 14th and the 15th. I could just feel my body wither away. My heart felt like it was just flapping in my chest because I had been up for so many days straight. I think what finally put me to sleep, even if just for a few hours, was the fact that I ate a few pieces of chicken and then took a nap in my office chair. It went on for this for like more than a year. Originally, I thought it was stress. Chubby Emu was breaking out in a way that I had never seen in the 2 years prior on YouTube. I had a video front page to the top of Reddit, and there was this constant buzzing at the back of my head about making a video that was better than my last. And I remember sometime that fall in 2017 that I went to a center for sleep disorders here in DC because I couldn't take it anymore. I talked to the fellow who was finishing up his program in neurology, and we were trying to hypothesize what could be the problem. Sometimes in Chubby Emu videos, I've made fun of suggesting cognitive behavioral therapy in times when it's not appropriate. And that comes from this encounter with the neurology fellow, because that was what he suggested. In fact, he was so convinced that that was the only thing that was going to help. Now, this is where I became the problem patient, because I know in my life, nothing about my behavior had changed at that point in time. The routine in my life had largely been the same for about 5 years. CBT wasn't going to do jack. I'll be honest, in my entire life, I've never experienced that level of insomnia. When you have something like that, you just become stressed when the night falls because you know that you're going to be miserable and frustrated and angry that you won't be able to fall asleep. And that dread of knowing that you're going to lay in bed, eyes wide open, and that you're going to see the sun rise in the same way that you saw the sun set 12 hours earlier just drains you mentally in a way that I never want to experience ever again in my life. And throughout all this frustration and dread and stress for months of not being able to sleep and then not being able to function the next day because I couldn't sleep, I finally cracked. I remember going to buy the groceries one night and seeing the 4-pack of Monster Energy drink. And I thought, you know what? I'm just going to drink one for dinner. It's not like I'm going to sleep anyways, so might as well just drink one as a screw you to my body. That way, at least I can sit up at my computer and write the next video. And so actually that night, I remember drinking 2 of those cans, and lo and behold, I didn't fall asleep that night. But what I did do was I fell asleep in the daytime the next day. And it wasn't just a little nap, it was like a full-on 6 hours where I was completely knocked out to the point that I couldn't remember that I had fallen asleep, so I woke up confused and my heart was racing when I woke up. That was the first time I had actually slept decently since October 11th, 2017. I didn't really know what had happened, so at nighttime again, I had another can of Monster because I expected that I'd stay up and watch the sunrise. But what started happening was that while drinking these Monsters, I was starting to be able to sleep again normally. Now here's the part that confused me. The Walmart in DC where I did my grocery shopping ran out of the sugar-free Monster, so I just stopped having the energy drinks for like a month. Within a couple of weeks, my insomnia came back. When the stock of energy drink came back, I started drinking them again, and I could sleep again. This made no sense to me at all, because energy drinks are what college kids use to pull all-nighters and stuff like that. You're wired when you drink them, and that's the point. But falling asleep after you drink one shouldn't be happening, but it was happening to me, and none of it made any sense. Until I looked at the nutrition facts, and then it all started to click. You see, B vitamins are something that you can become deficient in pretty quickly if your diet keeps becoming more and more scarce, especially in animal proteins like mine did. Vegans know this pretty well because, at least in the past, they needed to make sure that they supplemented with vitamin B12. One of the big reasons why I was able to slim down so quickly was that I drastically cut out my protein intake. I realized that I had miscalculated the protein content of chicken in March of 2017, so I swung the pendulum the other way and underconsumed by a lot. And you often see on these energy drinks that B vitamins are a way to supply more energy for you. That's a weird marketing tactic because B vitamins do help with ATP pathways, which are for cell energy, but you're not going to feel more perked up because of B vitamins. Severe B12 deficiency does cause neurologic problems. It's called subacute combined degeneration. This includes things like psychosis and blindness in extreme cases. I've described these on Chubby Emu. I've seen these before with my own eyes, but it didn't click in my head that it was happening to me. At the time that I was figuring this out, I ordered a blood test for myself, and I really did have high homocysteine and methylmalonic acid levels, which are vitamin B12 deficiency. In clinic, you can do direct vitamin B12 levels, but the assays have high rates of false negatives, false positives, and individual variability, so usually get the intermediates instead. So there it is. I had developed vitamin B12 deficiency because of my self-imposed dietary restrictions in 2017. I could have done a peripheral blood smear and all these other ones, but the lab tests from the blood test were enough for me to figure what was going on. From those restrictions, I probably depleted my liver stores of vitamin B12, and humans don't make B12 on their own. And as a screw you to my own body, I started drinking energy drinks at night, which happened to be rich in vitamin B12. And so I accidentally cured my own insomnia that way. It's funny how even having this knowledge and having the clinical know-how and experience of treating this deficiency, when it's happening to you, it just hits different. If you don't have a vitamin B12 deficiency, which you probably don't, at least in the way that I did, this worked for my freak accident situation. I now supplement my B12 with a multivitamin, and I don't drink any energy drinks currently. If you want more of an explainer on vitamin B12, I talk about it on Chubby Emu in the video about the boy who ate only chips and french fries for 10 years, and with the mom who ate 5-day-old sushi, links in the description below. Thanks so much for watching. Take care of yourself, and be well.